Recording. We are here. Sound check, live feed up. We're Yorik and Martin here. Yorik from FreeCAD, Martin from Open Source Ecology. Okay, so we want to discuss the state of CAD and collaboration, how we can work together. So I've looked at some of the recent work you've done on your... Oh, Jonathan, join us. Very nice. So, Jonathan, we're recording. Jonathan's our community manager, to introduce you. So yeah, we just started recording this for posterity. So, I was just mentioning, I read the recent article. Jonathan, have you read Yorik's recent article about the state of FreeCAD and the architecture module and some of the CAM work that's happening in there?
No, I haven't had a chance to review it.
Okay, but we're going to get to the bottom of all of this here. So Yorik, maybe, we can discuss the state of FreeCAD, because as we're going forward with open source ecology, we're seeing that collaborative CAD, achieving truly collaborative CAD efforts is very important for us as an organization. And we want to start migrating to FreeCAD as much as possible, pending all the different features being there. So what I'd like to hear from you first is, where do you see... As a lead, one of the lead develop, so you're one of the three lead developers on the FreeCAD project, correct? And what is the current state? I'd like to first assess that. For example, if we're building our CEB press, can we actually edit? Like, if we have a step file right now that we put into FreeCAD, can we actually edit it effectively, or is that functionality limited? Or
it depends, I would say. That's the normal answer for everything. But let's say like this. Yes, FreeCAD is stable enough, I think, to do production work already. I use it for work, and you can rely on it to like not lose data, keep your work going consistently, and be able to go back to correct mistakes and that kind of stuff. So I consider it, let's say, stable enough for real work, where you cannot make mistakes and you cannot lose work. So that's more or less guaranteed. The file format is something stable now that you can go away at. That you can tweak and you can open and fix things, so your work with FreeCAD is safe, let's say. Now, there are a couple of missing things, and everything will depend on if those missing things are like fundamental for you or not.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, what's missing is not so much as the functionality, but the tools made for the user, for the end user. That mm-hmm. means that sometimes you don't have the necessary tool, and you have to do some code, some Python coding, some scripting, some alternative way to obtain things. Mm-hmm. But in the background, everything is there. Is actually FreeCAD is already much more powerful than it looks.
Oh, I see.
Because mm-hmm. we start implementing things always very low level. Like, we begin with the functions and the functionality, and we make it available to Python. Then, when it works correctly, we begin to build the user interface for it. But user interface is something very complex and complicated, and that depends a lot on
mm-hmm.
user workflows, and so it's a complicated matter that takes time. That's it, basically.
I see.
So if, let's say, everybody now who uses FreeCAD for production work uses Python a lot, does a
I
lot
see.
Of Python scripting. Like, you don't have the tool that makes your special piece, banded piece, the way you want, so you have to script it, and then you can do it the geometric kernel of FreeCAD is really powerful, and it can do that kind of stuff. Like, the possibilities are limited. You have all the NURBS tools, all the I mean, you have all the necessary tools for any that match any commercial solution.
I see.
Now, about your question about step files. No, probably you will import step files and it will come as dump solids and pieces. Mm-hmm. So, the things you will want to modify, you will probably need to delete some pieces in redo and redo them.
Let's discuss two use cases that we have right now. It'll be very interesting to us. So let's not even talk about the brick press, which is already a step file. What I do see happening is the import of the step pretty much loses all the tree structure. In other words, you just get individual parts, right? Yeah. Okay. But we've used that before simply to make instructions. We pretty much label all the parts, we group them, and then we would do things like instructionals where we would show the build by hiding and unhiding parts. That's very useful. Now, but the next step comes in, can you design stuff? So starting with, for example, the design, what's the module called for part design? So part design?
Part design.
Yeah. So you can design parts, you can extrude them and so forth. And what is the state of the assembly? So you can make assemblies, multiple parts. Any limitations on that? What are the current...
The assembly is... It's a long story.
Mm-hmm.
The assembly module is something that was started by Jürgen, who is the boss of FreeCAD. He's the father of FreeCAD.
Mm-hmm.
And there have been a couple of months now where he didn't work on it because he switched jobs and he had no more time for FreeCAD. And he's back. Actually, he came back on that last week, saying now my job is okay. I have time again to put in FreeCAD. So I believe it will the development of the assembly module was a bit stopped, and I believe now it will restart again.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a good news. The bad news is that it's unusable at the moment. It's not ready. It's not finished, and it doesn't work.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, you have to wait more for it.
Mm-hmm.
That said, for me, for my point of view of architect, I've little use for it because we usually don't want to bind pieces together, or let's say it's not important for us, like to have those relationship between objects. For us, it's more important to have the structure and like geometrical constraints between objects is not so important for us, and. Well, everybody who uses FreeCAD at the moment find his way to do without.
Mm-hmm.
There is a second assembly module now. One of the guys from the community like grew tired of waiting and began to work on his own alternative version, which is called Assembly 2.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a Python script, so it's really, you don't need to recompile. You can just go to the forum, look for Assembly 2. It's on GitHub too, and you can just plug it in your FreeCAD install. And this one has a couple of tools, basic tools that we will have in Assembly. Like, for example, you can put constraints like actual constraint between two objects, or face on face, or point on point, that kind of stuff. And you can have constructions, you can construct assemblies like that. There are there are not so many tools, but let's say people who use it like it. So it works quite mm-hmm. nicely already.
Okay.
So if this might just fulfill what you need.
Okay.
And then problem with assembly is solved. You can just keep using this one.
Uh-huh.
So you should look at this one and see if it's enough for you.
Right. So tell me about why in architecture you don't need assemblies. Does that mean you have a building that's one part? You have multiple parts, clearly, right?
Let's say, no, you have several parts, but nothing prevents you from placing your objects at their real position. Like, for example, let's say I have a slab, and then I will put walls on it, and I will put my slab at the right place, and I will put my walls at the right place on top of mm-hmm. my slab, and I will put a second slab to make the roof.
Mm-hmm.
I just build those objects and place them at the right position. I don't need to bind them together.
Okay.
Like the big advantage of the assembly module would be that if I move my floor slab, all the walls and all the rest would move together because they are like linked.
Mm-hmm.
Or let's say there is a constraint between the walls and the slab that makes that when a certain face of the slab moves, the glued faces of the other objects will move together.
Right.
That's so important for architecture because architecture is rather fixed. So you don't move stuff around very often.
Mm-hmm,
and,
mm-hmm. So what to address?
Would be nice for that, like there are obviously cases where it would be nice, like for example a window that would move together with its wall and that kind of stuff, but
mm-hmm.
we can manage it now, like it's a little thing that would be better, but it works without.
Right.
You can really build models, complex models, without that assembly module. You just place manually your parts mm-hmm. where they need to be.
Okay. How do you align things if you want to put the wall on top, or say the floor on top of a wall? How do you have the exact alignment? You just script that,
because
or how do you?
The architecture module use snapping. That means you move, you draw a wall, and then you can move it from one endpoint to an existing point of another object. So
you can,
for example, align one corner of a wall with the corner of a slab. That works pretty well. That works only in the architecture module, not only in the architecture module, in the draft module and in the architecture module. Actually, it's from the draft module. But several tools of the draft modules, such as move, rotation, scale, and those generic tools, work with
mm-hmm.
all of the FreeCAD objects.
Okay.
Even in other words. So you would have snapping available also in part design if you use the draft tools. If you use draft move, you will have snapping. So you
can snap to endpoints, corners, lines, surfaces, or?
Yes, there are like 10 or 12 different snap locations.
Oh, no problem.
Circles.
So I can design. So for example, for the brick press, I mean, we don't have, I mean, at this point, we don't need the assembly. Because our machines are simple enough, and in fact, I don't really. I mean, in some places it might be convenient, but not necessary, right? I mean, is there?
No, I believe. Yeah.
Right.
And it's more. Actually, the main point of assembly is the constraints, the object to object constraints.
Like, for example, can you give me a good example? Like, for example, a bolt that fits through a hole, or?
Exactly. Or, for example, you have the axle that is rotating, and you have a holder, and you want both to be centrally aligned. That the center of the holder and the center of the axle are at the same on the same line, and that module will keep things aligned. That if you move one, the other will move as well.
But you can also snap the edge of the shaft, right?
Or there are several ways. Or you can start building them exactly on the 0-0 point, and then move both together to another place. There are many, many ways to make sure things are at the right place, and it's not so hard.
Okay. Do you think that, I mean, currently, compared to SketchUp, can you draw anything that you can draw in SketchUp in FreeCAD?
Geometrically, yes. I mean, even more, because SketchUp is a mesh modeler that internally everything is triangles.
Uh-huh.
Even if it tries to hide it from you. But if you try to do some weird things like a cylinder cutting another curved surface, you will see the triangles.
Right.
And then the messy things will begin to happen. And FreeCAD it has a mesh module. It means you can import or work with mesh objects, but that's not the main its main system. The main geometry type of FreeCAD is BREP, which is shapes that are defined by their closing surfaces.
What's it called?
That means that's basically like AutoCAD does like that, SolidWorks, CATIA, all that family of tools.
What is that system of geometry called?
It means basically that you have the notion of solid, that an object knows what's inside and what's outside always. And if you remove a face, it's not solid anymore. And I mean, it knows it's not solid anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And including many of the FreeCAD workbenches only work with solids. Like if you do something and you lose your solids, it would give an error. Because it wants to have always solids. And these solids are defined by their boundaries surfaces. Sure. That means that you have flat surface or curved surface, like NURBS surfaces. Everything works perfectly the same way. So you can have really, really complex things and do complex things. Like you have, for example, you have a piece that's made with one straight face and one curved face. And you can calculate the fillets between the flat face and the curved face. And it will be perfect, mathematically perfect. And because all those surfaces are mathematically defined. So you have absolute precision. And for those very complex curved things, you definitely have a big advantage over things like SketchUp.
Yeah. Okay. So let me ask you this. So
the big difference is that SketchUp is easy. SketchUp is like drawing, extruding, and you go very fast. In FreeCAD, you won't go that fast because you do things more. You begin to draw your 2D perfectly. You put dimension on that 2D. Then you extrude. Then you do the finishes, and it's a slower modeling process.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main difference, basically.
How much speed do you lose in terms of being able to model an object? I mean, is it twice as long, perhaps, or twice as much time?
Maybe twice as long.
Mm-hmm.
It depends. Simple things are very quick. Complex things take exponentially more time.
Mm-hmm.
So, like drawing a rectangle and then extruding, is almost as fast as in SketchUp. Now doing those kind of complex things with curves begin to add a lot of complexity and a lot of time.
Yeah.
But it depends.
Okay.
If you stay with let's say you don't use curves, you go quite fast actually.
If you don't use curves?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like you don't have many curves in your object.
Yeah, for example, for the brick press, we don't have we have very few curves. It's mostly straight edges.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You don't lose that much heat.
Okay.
It also depends on how precise and how constrained you want your things to be.
Mm-hmm.
For example, let's say you draw a 2D L shape, and then you will extrude to form a profile. A corner piece. That L shape, you can just draw it, or you can constrain each of its dimensions, like its length, its width, and put a parameter on these dimensions that you can change afterwards. All that work of putting these dimensions, these constraints, adds complexity and time. So it's kind of trade-off to see how deep you want to go.
Mm-hmm. Okay. But
basically, it depends. In the 3D world, there are like different opinions about that that question.
Yeah.
Some people think you have to be extremely correctly defined, the most as possible, and other people think that you have to go faster and make lots of more different objects and level them correctly and just delete them when you want to change them.
Mm-hmm.
Delete them and you're ready.
Okay. So for example, use case. Brick press. Let's see, can I share my screen? No, I can't. Somehow my screen sharing is not working. But let's see, let's go to